What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes. And today, we are going to be taking out these two Rheem and WeatherKing R22 central air conditioning condensing units and putting in two of the Mikey Pipes by ACiQ 36,000 BTU heat pump outdoor condensing units. These are the awesome ones. They have that nice dark gray color and they're side discharge, saving space when you have side yard clearances based on your local jurisdiction. It's gonna be awesome. And because those two condensing units, well, that one's about a foot on the property line and that one over there, about 2.5 feet. And you know, that's no bueno. The local building inspector said, you know you're not gonna put them back there, right? And I said, will you let me put a ductless mini split outdoor condenser unit on the wall? He goes, yeah. I was like, awesome. And here we go, we're gonna do it like this. Bow! Now, an old mentor of mine once told me that a happy workspace is a clean workspace. So as I'm uncrating my equipment, I'm piling it up, I'm making everything nice and neat and organized, and that way when we have to clean up later, it's just easier. Plus, you're not working amongst garbage. Smash that thumbs up button if you agree with me. All right, here are the two outdoor condensing units. A side note, something different than the previous condensing units that we installed for ACiQ, they're bolted to the pallet. And I gotta tell you, that's annoying. That is annoying because that's one more step to take in the installation process. Now, I get it. It keeps it secure to the pallet. But Fujitsu doesn't have to bolt their equipment to the pallet. I'm just saying. Come on, ACiQ. Why are we bolted to the pallet? And you know what's really crazy? We have this concentric vent kit from the condensing boiler that's in the basement, and it's discharging right into the side of this 2.5 ton outdoor condensing unit. Talk about poor planning. So, is that Kev? No, it's Daniels. You're a manhandler. You manhandled that beast. Is that the one that was, no, that's not the one that was facing the highly acidic boiler exhaust.
Yeah. I'm surprised that coil isn't more disintegrating from that.
Yeah, we're going to check that out, take a closer look. Were you going all the way there with it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. We're going to call our scrap metal guy, Julio?
Yeah.
Nice.
Thanks for sleeping
here, man. Yeah. Sweet. All right. I was able to get the bolts out using a 13 millimeter socket. So now I'm gonna set my wall mount brackets. Daniel's gonna get rid of the other condensing unit, and then we're gonna mount these on the wall. It's gonna look beautiful. All right, first condensing unit is now installed. Wow, that looks gorgeous. That looks absolutely gorgeous. Beautiful. Look at that. Beautiful. Don't you agree, Daniel?
Yeah.
Do you think it looks tits?
It's very nice.
Such a good Catholic schoolboy. All right, we're going to now install the second wall mount bracket. I'm going to show you step by step how we do this. It's quite easy. We have the Rector Seal. Is this my Rector Seal? Yeah, the Rector Seal WBB something. Oh, where is it? The 87733. Yeah, WBB 300. We're going to put that on the wall. We're going to try to make it at the same elevation as the other one and have some space here as well, but also be mindful of this egress basement staircase. So let's get this on the wall. And then this line set, we're going to cut this line set out and we're going to go straight up on this one. across and then to our attic location for the air handling unit. By the way, it's a walk-up third-floor attic with a spiral staircase. That's going to be a little fun next week when we install the air handling units.
All right. That's an elevation, you think?
Touch.
Right there?
That looks good.
Okay, so let's get one right there. Let's get one right there. Let's get one right there. Right there. And right there. Beautiful. So, right there. My Sharpie's now going to be deformed. Okay. Now, a lot of the weight is on the right side, but we are good. Gotta start off slow, otherwise I may skip around on it. Next hole. Right there. Now, they are going to ridicule me now. We are not going to use the right tool for the job. They are going to sodomize me in the comments section down below. Mikey Pipes is going to use Daniel's Nippix. And they are going to have a field day in the comments section down below. I'm telling you, they are going to have fun.
Oh, you know what I saw? Somebody turning the hammer drill, the hammer, to push the bolts in.
Oh, but then I need the adapter for it. Hi, good morning. Oh, you got filmed.
Yeah.
Make sure we're still 24 inches from center to center. Oh, we're off a little bit. Center, center. Okay, let's move this forward. Let's move that one forward. And let's go get the condensing unit. Sweet, sweet!
Sweet, sweet!
All right, Daniel's working on the electric. Excuse me, thank you. I am going to run nice 100 millimeter brown line hide
We're gonna go up, across, and then an inside, the outside corner to go up a little bit. Daniel thinks that there is gonna be plywood behind the vinyl siding. I'm gonna bet you that this house is like the house next door and there's brick. So, let's see what happens. All right, Daniel actually won the bet, even though he didn't bet. So we were able to, with screws, screw in our line hide to the plywood that's behind the vinyl siding here. Right now I have a 19-foot length of pipe, of 3/4 pipe going straight down. It's insulated. We're going to push that up. I'm going to run my 3/8 next. I'm going across with a 20-foot length. I have from here to there is, I think, 13 feet. And this is 19 feet. We're going to keep track of the total developed length because we're going to charge by length of pipe when we're all done at part two, when we install the air handling unit in the attic. And the other one that's in the basement, we're pretty good there. We're about 20 feet total length. So not bad. The two condensing units are installed. Daniel's done with the wiring almost. And we're just going to finish up this line set and put the front covers on after we get the communication wire in place and put the covers on. And I'm on one of three ladders. See, ladder one, ladder two, ladder three. And there's three guys on site and it is 10:15. Think two at a time, huh? All right. Don't impale yourself on the fence. Oh, you lost both of them. Damn it, Daniel. All right, we are... Hi, Nana Claire.
Hey.
All right. We still got to do this section of line set. While I was up there cutting a piece of line cover, Daniel put the hacksaw on top of the outdoor condensing unit, and the brand new anchor and screw set fell out behind the unit, and there's a million of them all over there. A million of them. They're everywhere. This is Mikey Pipes, Mikey Pipes News Network. Peter Campbell, do you have anything to say about how your brother dropped a whole brand new thing of anchors and screws on the floor in the dirt? Anything to say about that?
Disgusting.
That's absolutely correct. I agree.
Oh, this sucks.
This does suck. There's a lot back there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Anchors up here.
Oh my god, look at them. At least that's easier to grab onto. You know, it'd be nice if I used to use a vacuum. Oh, you're dropping them. Oh, and they're on there too. Damn.
They were everywhere all inside the unit.
Oh my god. Yeah, I still see one inside the unit right there. Wow. Oh my god. You know, the folks over at ACiQ, I'm sure they're laughing their asses off right now. They're laughing, watching this video. I don't know. Daniel, if you cost me this brand deal. Well, ladies and gentlemen, check out that nice control board right there. And don't worry, ladies and gentlemen, we installed two of the ICM 518s. This is their split phase surge protection device. I think this is a category 2 rated. I have to double check. Yeah, type 1 or type 2, right? So we're using the existing disconnect panels. They looked really nice. I didn't see a need to change them. But most importantly, we are no longer having to have the condensing boiler dumping the exhaust gases right in front of the coil. That was insane. That really, really was insane. But these two systems got installed with precision. It looks great. Until Daniel dropped the whole thing of anchors on the floor. You think maybe, just maybe, the folks over at Diversitech, you think they're watching right now and they'll send me another 540-AK100 plank plastic anchor kit? You think they'll send me one?
You could try.
I could try. If someone from Diversitech is watching right now,
feel bad for Daniel.
We should get them to send you mini split condensate pumps.
Yeah, we don't use that many of them though.
The warm-over.
But what I really would like is for Rector Seals to send us a bunch of these wall mount brackets that I exclusively love to use. I think they're awesome. I really do think they're awesome.
I kind of wish that they came like out a little bit more.
So they make a different model. Because you don't want to have, you know, them out all the time. Because we have in our shop. And, you know, sometimes they come out too far.
Yeah.
You know? But this really came out nice. This wall is a little off. So we're going to have to figure that out. But other than that, it looks nice. All right. That's 11:25. We're cleaning up. See that? Looks like it's been there forever. All right. We have a length of extra 20-foot pipe here. We're going to use that for the first floor system when we're back here next week. Homeowner had a difficult time taking 2 days off, two consecutive days. So we arranged with the homeowner that we're going to install the outdoor equipment and run the line set for the second floor system when she's not home. There's no need for her to be home. We're not going to be inside the house. Everything worked out perfectly. We ran new line set from over there. Sorry, the sun. Let me back up a little bit to show you guys. So from that corner, across, down, I use that little piece of accordion right there, and we will connect it to the condensing unit using the flaring tool next week when we install the system. This one is already electrically connected. Line voltage. There's our low voltage communication wire. Just need two wire. We're using the full communicating abilities for this system. Even the thermostat, which looks like an Ecobee, it's built in Wi-Fi, also a communicating stat. It's gonna be awesome. Make sure you guys check out part two. Now, before we clean up and we're up out of here, I gotta do a little branding. Nice raised dome sticker there, partially raised dome. It is a nice sticker. You can apply that yourself. They give you all the stickers to put on, or you private label it. And there it is, folks. Mikey Pipes by ACiQ. It's awesome. Not one, but two. Very, 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 very nice. Very nice. Very, very nice installs. Sweet. And don't forget to install your surge protection device on the indoor air handling equipment. Trust me, you don't want to miss that. And check out part two next week, when we install the indoor air handling equipment on both zones, start up and commission the equipment. It's gonna be awesome. Really, really is gonna be awesome.